Hello and welcome. This video will be a review of IBM ThinkPad 760, which code name 5947. So let's go on the basic specs of this notebook. Here I have a basic specs written by myself. Hopefully you will be able to read it. So it has a CPU Intel Pentium 1 processor, which runs on around 120 megahertz. Memory is the Edo RAM, which I forgot to write it. So give me a mo. Let's write it down. So, hello Edo RAM. Okie dokie. So graphic is Trident 9385 with 1 or 2 megabytes. Let's say direct 8.0, said to me it's half of megabytes, but Lenovo and IBM page said it's 1 or 2. Anyway, it's without the accelerator, so whatever, mate. HDD is IBM basic for this model, which runs on 4000 or 5400 RPM, which is, as you can see, 810 megabytes. Battery is let's say ion, Li-ion, and it's dead, so I cannot actually now tell you how it would work. Sometimes it keep the voltage for minutes or two, but usually it's just that. Anyway, the sound is ESA, or let's say ES1688, and it's pretty much fine, equivalent of later on Sound Blaster cards. Display is 11.3 inches DSTN passive, not active matrix display, but bigger than the TFTN, which was much more expensive that days, and it ran like 80x60 pixels. The laptop also contains ERDA, so IRDA, so infrared on the standard 1.0, also ultra bay tick, which could contain CD-ROM/1.44 FDD. So floppy drive thing in the package, and also contains 2x Type 2 card bus slots, or 1 Type 3 optional. Mine contains 2x card bus slots. So if we look at the case, let's hope it will be fine. I will turn on this fucking car lamp, so hopefully it will look much better. So let's look at the case. The cover is nice. Okay, this light is not so fucking nice, so let's put this here. Okay, the cover is nice in touch. You can see many, because of this IKEA lamp, many sheets going on. So let's focus it better. Okay, but it's shit anyway, so let's turn off this lamp. I think I'm recording this thing with iPhone SE, so the quality of this image could be shit, but let's hope marks. Okay, the mark on here is 3D IBM logo. The ThinkPad name on this, which is, I think, kind of cool. But this phone is so slow. Anyway, it's kind of nice. It's 3D, not a regular one. Shitty 2D thing. And let's check how the sizes go on with the ports. Okie dokie. So we put this heavy laptop, because on the standard, today's standards, is sort of heavy. On the left side of it, we have audio port for the phones and double port for mic in and also mic out port stuff, which is, let's say, pretty amazing on that sort of computer. The quality of this is extremely well done. Look at the cover. Man, this looks awesome. Here is an extension for telephone port. So let's say typical phone port, not LAN. And also for additional one, which was introduced a few years before, in 1995, which another model, so for audio and also video connector for external lifetime transferring audio and also video stuff. Anyway, sorry for my English. I will try to do this in one take. Hopefully it will work. Anyway, on the front, we have, in my option, CD with a great nice button, also indicator. Here is the ERDA, first port. I forgot to mention, there's two of them. You will see another in the back of this laptop. Played for some ID card or number if you work at the company. This shit looks broken, but it's actually just dirty. Okay, anyway, on the right side, we got locking mechanism, also two power buses, which one contains modem stuff, PC modem, just basic one from that sort of era, and also PS2. Let's hope I will be able to put this back inside. I'm a right-handed man. Anyway, that was awesome. Okay, from the on the back, we have infrared, and we unlock this cover. We have like power port, COM port, parallel port, so for the printer, VGA port. For external docking station, port 1, and also port for floppy. Here supposed to be also port for joystick, but this model doesn't include it. If you look closely, if we look here, here is the another pull-off button. On the left side of the model, we have... I just look on the left side of the model, so let's take back. So here we have a sticker from Windows 1995, which is awesome, and also some sticker with the name of the model and also with the other fancy features and stuff. Here is nice. It's like not so hard rather. Anyway, let's turn this machine off. The only thing which I sadly need to tell you about this stuff here is like, you see, it's broken. So that's why this fancy chocolate from Germany is laying here. Just wait a second. Let's turn this thing on and around. Let's put this chocolate inside the power cable and check it out. Okay, if you turn this thing up, the keyboard goes up, goes down, goes up. Anyway, first, before we turn this on, check how well it's made. It's like perfectly, no budget sheets. Okay, let's check out. Here's another perfectly nice IBM logo, also 3D one, not so. Mic in and contrast and brightness at the screen. Here we have like in the LCD indicator, volume one, software one is inside the Windows. This is a hardware one. Here's like track point one, fancy IBM keys, which can be locked by putting it like here, if you type. Ugh, this keyboard is so cool. Like, in the next video, I would like to post how the thing is working. Here we have like two speakers, because it of course fully functional. Let's check it out from the distance. Hopefully the focus will work. So let's check it out. It's great. Like, if you think the keyboard is probably German, because I have this all umlaut and stuffs, but it's in perfect condition, as you see. Typical for IBM, they have no Windows flag. There was nothing like that nowadays. And nowadays it is. Okay, let's check. I needed double press this leather, sorry for that, and let's check how it looks inside, because here started going be my English is shit, extremely interesting stuff. Like, all of this is on extension, so let's make this quick. I will tell you, let's just read. We have this IBM 810 MB this hard drive, and we can go with stuff like this. You can take this out. Well, of course, I don't want to break anything, but let's check it out. We have like CD from Hitachi. Lithium battery. As well as fancy before parts. Oh, it's going to fall if I don't take it out. Okay, let I change my idea. It will be two-part with the video. Hopefully you will still like this channel, but I just talk too much. Here beneath that is the Edo RAM, and the last thing in this video is, as you can see, you can put it here, stuff like battery, external one like here, or because you can leave this on and you can put the hard drive or the battery or another thing, and here's the protection password thing.